the hug and pull hug. Then if you want, you can do it with a knife or with your fingers. And go into it. And I'm still leaving the root part. Tricky things. I said to you to keep your left hand closed. Now we need flat, because I'm going to hold the opponent, like I said before, for the celery, on the bottom of the chopping board, and I'm not even working like this, because I know where is the knife, I know where is the onion, I just stand up. If you are like this, you are not comfortable for cutting. I'm going to do a middle cut on the onion, but I'm not going through. I just leave a little bit of the last part of the onion to pull together all the leaves of them. Then I turn in the onion and I keep the point of the knife the same part where I cut it. And I do the incision and I cut it through to the chopping board. Like the same thing, they look like a little strips. More fine you want the onion, the chopping dice of onion, more close you can do the strips. Bigger do you want it? Bigger is going to be the strips. And we cut it here. Then the last part, just for safety, instead of keeping your hand on top, you do a tunnel cut. You hold the onion and you cut it. Now it's almost done. I'm not frying it. I turn it again. I hold the onion together. And it's already done. See how many times I cut the onion? I think three cuts, I have a dice onion. Yeah. I don't need to chop it like this. You finish the cut. I'm usually don't do it this part because when I work in the kitchen, I still have a